Guys, this was so interesting to see. I'll tell you, when I first got out there to shoot this story, I was shocked by the size. Really not much smaller than the news desk right there. These were huge. And not only are we talking about crop dusting, but also feed and seed, helping with wildlife. It was fascinating. Take a look. Working the land from the sky. Farming, arguably the oldest profession in the history of mankind, now going high tech.
My name is Mike Bradford, and I'm the owner of SkyTech Drones.
Mike Bradford grew up on a farm just outside Pocasset. He now runs a drone company with his son Isaac.
I just kind of had a vision when the drones come about and how spray drones can help the agriculture community.
Instead of using planes or helicopters to spray the fields, they use drones.
Yeah, across the street here, a farmer here in Tuttle, Oklahoma, John Osborne, we sprayed some defoliant on his cotton. This pasture we're in right now, we sprayed a herbicide on it.
The Bradfords tell me it's a cheaper and safer option than traditional crop dusting methods.
Speaking to a farmer the other day, he was talking about how expensive like a helicopter is. I mean, like $1,000 an hour is a number he give. The overall cost, the insurance, the fuel, you know, and you also have a pilot.
According to the FAA, there have been hundreds of crashes involving crop dusting planes over the last decade, many of them deadly.
It is a lot safer application, I think.
But it is new, especially in an industry rich in tradition. So we asked if anyone has been resistant to farming with drones.
Absolutely. Some of them older farmers, like even like my dad himself, they're not. But once they see it.
Yeah, there's been many instances where a farmer calls us, was like, hey, I just want you to come spray 100 acres. Then they come down there and they watch us actually spray it and they realize how cool it is and how efficient it is. And they're like, okay, yeah, I want you to do a whole lot more.
So how exactly does it work?
This is the DJI T40, and empty weight, it'll weigh around 100 pounds. But when it's full of chemical, it holds 10 gallon of chemical, it'll weigh about 200, 210 pounds at takeoff.
And believe it or not, it actually doesn't require much manual flying. Instead, programming.
Task complete. Return to home.
When the team gets a job, they fly a much smaller drone over the area to get an aerial picture.
So this is part of the planning going into the spray jobs, because, I mean, we've talked to a lot of people and they're like, man, it can't really be that difficult. You just go out and spray.
Then they create a map with boundary points, pretty similar to what a robot vacuum uses to map your house.
So you have to be very precise on here to get the effective coverage.
Then they send up the drone with a full tank of chemical or seed or feed and let it fly.
We send a drone out. I'll be piloting a drone and then he'll be piloting the other drone, and it goes out, it holds 10 gallons of chemical. Once it gets done spraying that, it'll come back in. We have a person sitting on the ground that grabs the hose from the trailer, refills the tank, also grabs the battery, changes the battery, and that happens about every 7 to 8 minutes.
And that may be one of the drawbacks. It will likely take longer to spray a field with a drone than with a traditional crop dusting plane. So with that, we asked the team if they think drones will ever fully replace the airplanes.
Well, I don't know if it ever replaced them, because like I said, there's certain applications that they do work just as well or better, and the drones do too.
So we had to ask Mike what he would have thought as a little boy on that farm outside Pocasset, seeing drones overhead a field.
I didn't think I'd ever see it. Obviously, you know, technology's come a long ways, but I never would have thought it.
But just as the tractor keeps plowing, the crops keep growing, the cows keep grazing, it now seems the blades on the drones will keep on spinning. Abigail Ogle, KOCO 5 News.